This is the sound of a small gasoline-powered airplane taking off. Now listen to a plane with electric motor. Gasoline-powered planes are noisy and expensive to keep, and they emit toxic fumes. Electric planes are quieter, cheaper to run, have zero emissions, and they are safer.
If you look at the safety you can build into, let's say, an electric motor, the reliability of that motor is many, many times more reliable than what we have in a traditional internal combustion engine.
Their only technical disadvantage is their short range, but with better batteries, that will change too. The most famous electric plane, Solar Impulse 2, equipped with solar cells, circumnavigated the world. NASA has been experimenting with electric propulsion too. Commercial companies are already showcasing their electric planes at air shows. German manufacturer Siemens has a lightweight two-seater that can even tow gliders. Alpha Electro, manufactured by Slovenian company Pipistrel, has an onboard computer that can predict malfunction and isolate a faulty battery cell.
The processing time of artificial intelligence right now is getting such, and the redundancy that can be built in, that we can provide very, very safe vehicles that are simple to operate and extremely reliable.
Recharging batteries typically takes between 45 minutes and 2 hours, and the flight time is about half an hour, which for now makes electric planes suitable only for training. However, there's one more obstacle, the same one that plagues self-driving vehicles, the lack of regulations. General Aviation Manufacturers Association is working hard to agree on standards covering electric-powered planes.
This will be an internationally accepted standards for certification of these vehicles, and that does a tremendous amount to be able to free up entrepreneurship and companies that want to be able to develop this in one country and be able to have their designs certified and validated all over the planet.
Experts say small electric-powered planes could be in commercial production within 5 years. George Putic, VOA News, Washington.